Hey guys, welcome back to another episode. Today we're going to talk about another book by Amish Tripathi, or we can say that another series from the Amish Tripathi, that is Ramchandra series. I finished reading the Ramchandra series. Not exactly, obviously the all books are not out yet. There are only three books out. Of one is Sign of Ishwaku, second one is Sita, and third one is Ravan. The other two will be launching soon, depends on the Amish. So I read this book and I finished reading, so I thought let's make a video on it, let's clear some of the doubts, let's talk about the book, what is this book about and how you can read, why, how you can read, because that's the really important point. I already made a video on the Shiva trilogy, you can go check on the channel, or there is a link in the description, you can check the video. I have completely made a detailed video on the Shiva trilogy, that why you should learn. Oh, most of you guys already read that, I know that, so why not let's talk about the Ramchandra series. So today we're going to talk about the first book of Ramchandra series, that is Sign of Ishwaku. Before we get into review, if you are new to this channel, do subscribe, press the bell icon so you will get notified whenever I upload a new video. I talk about books, I talk about marketing, I talk about freelancing, I talk about how you can make money online by home, because that's what I do for my living, that's what I do for, you know, from the last couple of years. So if you want to know more about it, then make sure you hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon, and definitely follow me on the Instagram. There are few things I really want to talk about before getting into the review, because these are really important. These are really important to understand. Otherwise, you will get disappointment. You will start hating this book, because we have heard a lot about the Ramayana from our childhood, from our grandparents, and we know certain plots, we know certain things, how move in the Ramayana. So this book, if you want to read this book, try to reimagine everything. Don't try to connect dot between what you know and what's in this book. Otherwise, you will get disappointment, highly disappointed. And if you don't want to get disappointed, it's my sincere request. Do not try to imagine everything from the scratch. Try to go with the author's perspective. Try to go with the what author is saying, because obviously, it's not like that everything is true, it's not like that everything is wrong. But whenever you are reading a new book, whenever you are reading a fantasy book, it's important to go with the imagination. It's important to create different kind of imagination. This book is purely based on the author's imagination. If you try to connect, you know, what happened in the Ramayana and what in this book, you will get disappointment and you will start hating the book, you will start hating the character, and I don't want to happen with you. So obviously it's happened with me, but I know that storytelling skills of Amish. I already read the Shiva trilogy, I already met author a lot of times, so I know how these things work. So it's my sincere request. I'm going to put just what is the positive points, what is the negative point of this book, and it's ultimately up to you to pick up this book or skip this book. But if you want to understand a new perspective, if you are the person who don't believe completely on Ramayana, it's kind of, you know, for 70%, 80%, then you can definitely pick up this book. But if you're a hardcore fan of Ramayana Mahabharata and you want everything, you know, as it is, then you will definitely hate this book. This is a really important point if you are starting to read the Ramchandra series, because you will get disappointed a lot of times in a lot of different way from starting to the end. So I don't want you to happen that. So try to imagine with Apple. Try to, you know, author storytelling kills it different, and he talk about new imagination, he talk about completely different scenario. So if you want to enjoy the new world, then definitely pick up this book. That's the sincere kind of, you can say it warning, you can say it as a sincere request or kind request. The first book of Ramchandra series is Sign of Ishwaku. You know, the first cover is all about it, that kind of cleavage, he is using this, he is aiming at somewhere, and the second cover after couple of months is the second cover. But I love the first cover most. I don't know why, maybe that bluish color, and I love blue color a lot because of that. But I love the first cover. But after, because of the continuity of the Ramchandra series, they changed the cover to the second one. You can see that cover on the screen. So this is the two covers, so don't get confused a bit with the cover. You can pick up anyone, you will find the same kind of content. This book is kind of 350 pages, around 300 plus pages this book. And if you love a big books, if you are a fan of big books, then you can definitely pick up this book. This book starts with, you know, in the starting, there is a description of each and every character, so you don't have to get confused between a lot of characters. Obviously, there are a lot of characters in this book, but the main character is obviously Ram in the first book of Ramchandra series. And the story gets started, but in the initial pages, there are characters details in each and every, like what are the characters, what are their names, what are their relationship, who they are, everything is given in the details at the starting of the pages. Then story starts, the first chapter talk about the kidnapping of the Sita, and story moves little bit and then shift back to the past. That Ram is the son of Dasharatha, and from the author's perspective, the birth of Ram is considered inauspicious, because here one side Dasharath start losing his battle, and here at that same moment Ram was born. So kind of, you know, people think that because of this happened, because of this happened. So kind of similarity authors try to imprint in your mind. At some point Ram realized that the father ruling, it's not that efficient, it's not that up to the point, it's not to control everything, but because of the being an ideal son, he tends to follow everything, he never go against them, he do not try to rebel against them. And there is a soft connection between the Shiva trilogy and the Ramchandra series. This book is little bit small connection between the Nagas and Vayuputras. I don't know why and how Amish think about it, maybe because he want to just connect the Nagas and Vayuputras in this book, that's why he added to it. And you may wonder, or you have already read the Shiva trilogy, then you will realize this point, you will at this point where Ram has to choose between two, then you will realize that this is connected to the Shiva trilogy. So you can say that Shiva trilogy is kind of little bit context in this book about this book is connected to the Shiva trilogy, and there are some points you can see the same context of the Mahabharata. Maybe Amish want to write something epic on the Mahabharata in the future. I don't know, this is just my prediction, I'm not sure, but maybe because of, we can see the context of the Mahabharata in this book. If we talk about the Sita Swayamvar, which is the most interesting part of this book, because most of the people disagree with this, most of the people agree with this, I have no idea. You can decide what you want, let me know in the comment. There is too much of imagination in the Sita Swayamvar, because we know that, I told you that there is a context of the Mahabharata, and we know that in Mahabharata there is a, in that Swayamvar there is a, you have to fish that eye, fish that moving, and this is the same thing happen in this book. So kind of, you know, a lot of imagination in this book, and I don't know what to say about this. I don't know what to say this thing, but there is a lot of imagination in this book if you talk about this Swayamvar. Another few point I don't liked, which is Ravan present at the time of the Sita Swayamvar, or we can say that the Ram and Ravan face each other in the multiple ways, and there are few references where Ravan was actually present at that moment. After the Sita Swayamvar, they came back to the Ayodhya, and few things happen, they talk with each other and blah blah blah. I'm not going to give each and every description, but I'm going to give you the positive and negative points in a bit. But they came to the Ayodhya, and after the discussion they go for the 40 years vanvas, or we can say the exile. Sorry for using the Hindi words, because I love sometimes using Hindi, so you can imagine Hindi words also. So after they go for the 40 years of exile, and after that this book end at the same point, which is kidnapping of the Sita. If you talk about the three book, I have already read the three books, so I will make another video on the Sita and the Ravan. All three books end at the same point, that kidnapping the Sita. So if you are reading, you can read any book standalone. It's not necessary that you have to read the each and every book to understand the series, to understand the sequence, just like the Shiva trilogy. If you want to read anyone, like I will suggest you to read either Sign of Ishwaku or the Sita of Warrior, because these two are my favorite books. I have not made any video on the Sita and the Ravan. I will surely make video on that book also, but these two are my favorites, and if you want to pick up, definitely pick up these two, any of this book. Now let's get into the point, the positive points and the negative points of the first positive thing about this book is imagination, like a lot of imagination, a very detailed imagination. Like you can see everything in your imagination. If you have a strong imagination, then you can just, when you are reading the book, you will understand that why, how the imagination is important and how you can imagine all those stuff. So first brownie point goes to the imagination. Second thing I loved about this book is high dose of philosophy. If you love philosophy, if you love philosophical concept, then you can definitely pick up this book, because a literally high dose of philosophy in this book, and you will definitely enjoy at some point. You will definitely you will like to connect with that plot. You will definitely go into that zone of imagination and you will try to digest all kind of philosophy. The third thing I liked about this book is connection of Shiva trilogy, I mean the Vayuputras and Nagas in this book. Fourth thing is obviously the cover I like the most because of that bluish effect. I don't know, but I love the blue color. Another point I loved about this is character building so much. I mean, if I talk about the character, I can go on and on, but I just don't want to go at it. If you talk about each and every character, the way they are building, the way the character is nurtured, the way that character is developed is so awesome that you can literally fall in love with the character. Another good or the hilarious part about this book is the meeting of Ram and Sita. I was like, oh my god, at that point, and the love between the Ram and Sita. You will definitely enjoy those epic points where you will feel a lot of connection between the character. I really enjoyed those things about this book. Another thing I liked about this book is the date of Roshni. It's kind of related to the Nirbhaya case. Author is trying to connecting the modern way and ancient way. He's trying to connect. So you can see that the Nirbhaya, you can immediately recall the Nirbhaya sequence in this book. Another point I loved is obviously the character building and the death of Jatayu, which is close to my heart. I don't know why, but I felt that. So this is all about the positive point. Now let's get into the negative point. The first negative point is all about the Sita Swayamvar, which is I don't like that much, which is I am not completely disagree, but not that much connection I felt there. Not that, you know, no, not that bonding with that particular situation. Second thing is this book is around 360 pages, so you can see that the pace is very slow and this book is moves very slow. I mean, if you don't have that much attention span, if you don't have that much capacity to sit and read continuous, then you will start hating this book or you will quit this book immediately. But this book is standalone, so you can pick up any book. But if this book is a little bit stretched, which I don't like, if I see from the audience perspective who are not that much into the reading, then they will start hating this book. Third thing is imagination. A lot of imagination is there. From the audience perspective, I can see that people don't connect with a lot of imagination. If you try to rebuild complete Ramayana in a complete new Ramayana or Ramayana V.2, version 2.0, then you will start hating it. So same thing happened. I know when I talk about this book, when I discuss this book with my friend or the bookstagrammer, they say that they don't like this part, they don't like this part. So I can completely agree with that. I'm not against anyone, even I'm not against or with your thoughts, but it's my sincere request. So these are the few points I don't like. But it's okay, in the lockdown everyone enjoys this book. I enjoyed this book. At some point you enjoy, at some point you don't enjoy. There are a few points obviously don't enjoy. One is Sita's Swayamvar, second one is the Ram, you know, the born situation of the Ram, then the Ravan present at the Sita Swayamvar. So these are the few things that I seriously don't agree with, but it's okay. At the end of the day, it's my point of view. Do let me know, what do you think about this book? Any particular moment that you enjoyed from this book or any particular moment that you hate in this book? Do let me know in the comments. And that's all for today's video. I guess I have covered positive and negative points. Now it's up to you to pick up this book or not. But I will suggest it's a one-time read. It's a good read to recreate a new Ramayana or to reimagine the Ramayana in a new way. So that's all I guess I can say about this book. I'm not going to give the rating about this book because that will be my own personal point of view. I want you to know your point of view. I want you to know your point of view in the comment section. Would love to know what do you think about this book. And I hope I have covered all the things. Now you can decide you should pick up this book or not. And that's all I guess for today's video about the Sayan of Ishbaku. I will soon post the Sita and the Ravan video soon because I love Sita book much as compared to this book. And this is a high dose of philosophy, let me tell you. And if it's a one time read, you can definitely pick up in this lockdown, or you can definitely pick up. There are two books are yet to launch from the author. So I hope you enjoy this video. Do let me know what you think, and don't forget to follow me on the Instagram where I post quotes, where I post book related details or the new launch or the new movies. I talk about a lot about in the Instagram. Go follow on the Instagram. So that's all for today's video. I hope you enjoyed this and see you in my next video. Bye bye.